what do people want to make sure is heard or said between now and the official meeting?
I'm concerned about parking. There's no sufficient for parking for two residents. And then I have a question and an issue about the retail, because retail is more and more going online. The stores are hurting. We'll just have one more empty space on the ground floor. You see all these, you know, the building that the bank is in is dead now. There's nothing there. I've been all over the country. Any new buildings, they have retail on the ground floor, apartments above, they all sit empty. I don't understand this business of wanting retail downstairs.
It's like a pretty big effort to have more commerce along the avenue, but.
Well, actually, I just did count of the storefronts in Aurora, Lutar, Ridge Avenue, Jindal, and Conrad. We have 86 storefronts, 74 of which are occupied with 12 vacancies now. And among the vacancies are, like, the taproom, which will be, I'm sure these stuff are going to be sold and open again very shortly. So business is coming for that. We have these big residential properties going up. I'm assuming the kind of people that live in there are the kind of people that want walkable, sustainable neighborhoods, and they look for places that have services that they can walk to. A lot of the businesses that are opening on the Avenue are health and wellness type of things, small yoga studios and things like that. They're not dress stores or, you know, the kind of retail we're used to as kids. They're places that people go to get their eyeglasses, to get PT, whatever. So as we have Jefferson University coming up at the top of the hill, they're making more and more of these types of businesses moving. And I think they're popular with the kind of young people who are living in neighborhoods like ours. So to kind of think that, well, you know, we can't rent retail, I think is a little bit more advanced, because I think it's going on now.